Time to play with some clay. All right, I've decided I'm going to take this support out. And the only reason I'm going to do that is because I can see it really running interference with the figure as I, on the design of the figure, as I work on it. So what I have to do to disconnect this from the armature inside is to cut away a section of its body, and undo the bolt that holds it, and hopefully not screw up the whole damn piece. Whoop, flame went out. I just got done rendering the film video for the last one, and I thought I'd come out here and do this because I had the idea while I was working on my video. Damn it. Well, I got a phone call at the wrong time. It was from a friend from out of state, and I hadn't talked to the person in a long time, so I took the call. What I'm doing here is I'm heating up the knife, and I'm cutting out the section while I'm talking to my friend on my cell phone. And I'm just, like I said, heating up the knife and cutting into the section. I'm going to be removing that midsection of the figure. It's not going to hurt the figure. It's just, you know, it's something I have to do because I have to get to the bolts inside the figure that are holding it to the armature. Now I take this expandable wrench here and I loosen the bolts that anchor it to the figure, and the armature is a strong enough armature that I got from sculpturedepot.net. They provide a armature made out of aluminum, and the even though it's aluminum, it's strong enough to hold this much clay up, especially the way I have him leaning against the rock with his hand. It gives it the stability I need to keep it in place. That's why I thought of taking this armature support out last night. Try to see, this goes in there. And that's, it worked out well. I just didn't see any future in that support back there because I could foresee it causing problems with the armature or the feathers and the figure, the anatomy of the figure. And he holds up pretty good. I mean, he's not going to go anywhere. This hand, even though it's just anchored a little bit by the clay, is enough to hold it in place, and these two legs are pretty strong. I did cut this up here at the leg and pull it down because the leg was just about that much shorter than that leg. And so now they're both the same length from the point of the hip to the knee. So now I'm just filling in those two spots, and I'm going to go to bed now because it's the night before you see this, and I just had this desire to do this at this time of night and get it over with and see if I could. And of course I could, just have to have the willpower to take something apart that you've worked pretty hard to get. Well, I haven't really worked that hard on this piece. This has been an easy piece. I can see a problem with his butt. It's too bulbous on this side. But it's all going to be fine. I just got to fill that all in. And you can see where the armature went into his back here, and I can just, you know, plug that up. It just takes away an obstruction that every artist has to deal with. I mean, artists have to deal with armatures and supports all the time with clay. I decided to do something about it. All right, I'll pick this up tomorrow morning or tomorrow afternoon and get this on the web tomorrow. Well, I went through some of my model shots on the little bighorn. I had a couple of Native Americans posing for me there of the Crow tribe. And the one thing I noticed is there's, you know, they may have muscles, but they're not so pronounced. I guess what I'm trying to say is they're just normal people, as anybody would suspect. But every muscle would not be shown. And certainly they had definition when certain muscles were exerted, but they weren't exerting them all the time. So it's take down the muscle time. I mean, they've got to look like people. You don't want them to look like superheroes. You want them to look normal. What you're trying to do is take a moment, and that's the beauty of nature, and that's the beauty of God's creation, is what I'm trying to capture over days and weeks is what happens in a split second in nature. God's creations are, well, they're beyond reproach. It's going to be so much easier to work on this without that armature support in the back. Another thing I noticed was, even though I'm putting some muscle definition into the shoulders, in real life it's not that defined. I guess what I'm trying to say is, if you're going to be an artist, you got to study nature.
I had to push the armature back in a little bit because it was sticking out too far this way. The nice thing about these armatures from Sculpture Depot is that they're made of aluminum, so it's easy to bend an errant wire. You gotta have the anatomy, you gotta have the bone structure, you have to have the bone points where the bones are on the surface, like the elbow and the like this bone right here. My uncle could always tell me the name of the damn muscles and the tendons and everything else, but I just never. He was a far better sculptor than I am, or still is. But he gave me some good pointers when I first started out. You gotta realize when I started out, it was back before the internet, so. You guys have got an advantage. Yeah, you can 3D print all day long, but to actually produce something with your hands and with your abilities, that's a whole different level. Whole lot more feeling of accomplishment when you actually do it. I'm a lot happier with this now than I was the other day. Cutting back on the musculature a little bit helps. There's still muscles that would expand and contract and fill out through the actions of the human body. And some of those would be in the shoulder of the warrior right here. Now a lot of this is going to be covered up with headdress, so I'm not going to worry about too much, but I still have to have the structure, and then I can work around that. Back in the 1960s, when I was in high school, I was taking an art class, and I used to get down in front of a mirror on the floor, and I'd hold myself up with one arm and draw the muscles in the shoulder, and I sort of remember it even now. That's how I kind of taught myself the anatomy, is just by observing my own. Of course, I was 100 pounds lighter back then. So, and a lot younger. I can't do that on the floor now. I get on the floor, it'd be hard for me to get up. That's what comes with old age. I'll kind of refine that. Well, that's as far as I'm going to take it today. next week I'll take down the legs a little bit more and also start working on his head. Because at some point I've got to, do the head of this guy. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.